myself, Sami Nazar. I am assistant professor in St. Martin's Engineering College, Dwalapalli, Hyderabad. And today I welcome you for electromagnetic theory session. So before I start, I would like to tell what electromagnetic theories are and where exactly circuit theory failed, and we need to invoke the electromagnetic theory. First, we'll begin with the definition. So, study of interaction of fields. From where we get fields are generated, fields will be generated from time varying or static charges or currents. So this is study of interaction of charges or static charges or currents. So we have studied about circuit theory. How circuit theory differs from electromagnetic theory? We consider here one source. We have a switch here that is closing at T is equal to 0. And we have a wire connected to this source. See, and this wire is open. There is no load connected here. How circuit theory people velocity, its length and shape. How it happens? Suppose we have a bend in a wire and then we have resistor and we are measuring it in oscilloscope. This is resistor R and this is bend in wire. So at time 0, when the circuit will close, how? For circuit theory people, they will consider this bend as a straight wire only. For them, this bend does not affect. But for EMT people, this bend affects. How does it affect? This is a wire that has some bend here. How they consider? If we are having low frequency of the source, that is, frequency is low, what they will consider? They will consider it as an inductor. And if we have high frequency, consider this band, where we consider this band as a transmission band. So these are the differences. For circuit theory, they will just take a straight line, so they consider lumped circuit. And for EMT people, there are two different frequencies. They will consider for low frequencies inductors, and for high frequencies transmission line. These all things we will be studying in transmission line chapter. So the shape of the wire effect. Now, how does this length effect? Suppose we are having one signal. How we consider what is electric potential? So we know we have two laws for calculating field. First law in general we calculate by Coulomb's law, and if we have symmetrical charge distribution we calculate by Gauss's law. But we have one more way of calculating electric field, which is much simpler. How it is simpler? That process is called calculating electric potential. Electric potential will also give information about the field. So why it becomes much easier? Because it is a scalar quantity. It is a scalar, and mathematics for a scalar compared to vector quantities, we get much easier steps in calculating scalar quantities. Suppose we have a field like this. We have a charge somewhere here, and we want to move from a point. This is our A. From A, say to B. So, for moving a unit charge from position A to B, we require some work to be done. How will you calculate this? And you should calculate this distance. This is half of this, and we are taking some elemental length, dl. And this is r distance. So, what force we need to apply? We know from the formula, force will be Q times of electric field. Okay? And for a small पोजीशन एट ए ए टू चार एट पोजीशन बी. सो वी नो फ्रॉम द डेफिनेशन ऑफ वर्क वी हैव what force we are applying and how much distance we have moved. So this is a small problem. And now we will integrate. So we will get for complete length from A to B. So what we will get? We will integrate. And force what we know? Force we know. Q times rho electric field. So we will substitute. What is this? What this negative charge is explaining? This negative charge is explaining that the work we are doing is because of the external agent, not by the field. So, and what is this work done per unit charge? This we call electric potential and we denote it as V of AB minus of E of B. So this is the mathematical formula for electric potential. Now we have conclusions regarding V of AB. What is V of AB? This position A gives information about initial point. And this B informs about final point. If VA is say if VAB is negative, then who is doing some work? Electric field is doing work. How I will explain. And if VAB is positive, external agent is doing work. And most important point, this B, AB is independent of path taken. So this is very important. How is it important? So it does not depend on path taken. Considering this, we can derive Maxwell's second equation, that is for that will be E dot dl equals to 0. And I will derive this also.